What's going on, everybody? My name's Waddles, and today I'm excited to die. Yes, you heard that right. I'm going to die today, maybe. Well, it's going to be sad if I die today. Today, the goal is to raid an ocean monument in 1.13. Now, technically, I'm in the snapshots right now, but I'm using the new mechanics. So, as you maybe know, if you raided an ocean monument before, you used fences for air pockets and all that kind of stuff because you can't really break blocks or whatever. Maybe you use water potions. I always use fences. Well, that doesn't work anymore, so I'm going to be using soul sand. I have all types of good gear here, and then a bow, of course. And then, after I raid this one right over here, I want to go and find another and try it with the conduit power. So we're just going to kind of experiment and see how much easier or maybe harder it is with the whole soul sand bubble pulling up mechanic. I think that's going to be better than magma blocks, because magma blocks will hurt me, right? I think. So the gear, real quick, what I have on my water sword, I have sweeping edge, sharpness, unbreaking. I'm not going to read all of the armor enchants. I'll just kind of hover over them. I went ahead and, of course, built this in creative mode, but I will be doing this in survival because we got to have the whole risk of maybe dying and that kind of stuff. So I have all of that kind of gear. I'm going to go ahead and give myself just a bunch of random blocks here, you know, just for shelter and all that kind of stuff. And I think it's time to switch over into survival and take this on. Okay, let's see how this goes. I'm gonna keep track of the deaths that I get during each battle. What the goal is to take out all three of the Elder Guardian boss things. If I don't do that, I didn't finish the temple. So I should be able to place that for air, and then I have to stand in it just like that to get air. Also, I should say that I think I saw this idea in the comments of a video, but I wasn't sure, couldn't find it. So maybe credit to you if you said this idea. I don't know. Where is an Elder Guardian boss? It helps that I have this Aqua Affinity helmet. I could imagine it being very difficult if I didn't have the Aqua Affinity going on, because this would be draining really, really fast, and I'd be having to do that. Now, obviously, air doesn't refill instantly anymore, too, so that makes it a little bit harder. I do need to wait in each bubble column for a little while, but I think there's usually one right over here, right? Somewhere near here, I think. I'm noticing the difference in frames for sure, but that's because I'm in a snapshot. Nothing in there. Let's go back. These are giant mazes, and I always feel like there's a sponge room. I always feel like I'm wasting your time by running through these things and going everywhere, but maybe I'm not. Maybe I'm overthinking it. I'm probably overthinking it. Anything this way? Yes? No? No. We aren't going to be able to break stuff, of course, because we do have this mining fatigue. So that's why I'm not doing that. We need to breathe real quick. I do like the new swimming mechanics already from playing around in here and swimming through here. It is a lot easier to go around this thing. So let's see. We got a dead end there. Got lots of bad guys in here. I'm trying to not die. I shouldn't die with this suit of armor. If I die with this suit of armor, that's pretty sad. A dead end sponge room. Cool. I can find all the sponge rooms when I'm in, you know, a world where I don't need the sponges. When I just did this in survival, I couldn't find any sponges. I have zero kills so far, but zero deaths also. Just thought about that. Okay, so we're at the entrance. Let's go this way now. That's a bad guy in there. Okay, so let's take him on. This is where I die because I'm impatient, and I try and fight things, and I rush them, and it's just not good. Take aim. There we go. That's my first bow shot. Right at an Elder Guardian boss. Now, of course, I know about tridents, and I could be using tridents, but I decided that it would be a little more fun. There we go, one down. I decided it would be a little more fun to do this with the old weapons and tools. And you know what I'm just realizing? I don't really need these torches in my offhand, because these sea lanterns are so bright under the water now. That is amazing. That is really nice. In the snapshots, in case you don't know, they changed how water or light spreads underwater. Yeah, that's it. Whoa. Whoa. Okay, careful about that while you're swimming. I'm noticing that's an issue, is this whole swimming thing and then hitting the ceiling. Maybe it's a snapshot thing. There should be one over here, though, I think. Yup, right there. What you looking at, buddy? I'll see you around. I hope. I shouldn't get too full of myself. They're all targeting me. Go away, guys. No, let me hit the boss. There we go. Okay, that's two down. There should be one more, but we're gonna need to get away and take a little munch here. Okay, yeah, two down. I think there's one. Oh, that's gonna be annoying. I mean, it's a nice little boost out of a room. I wonder if I could use that to my advantage, but it's also, I could see that being really annoying. Okay, dead end though. Let's go back this way. New recipe, huh? Oh, I must have not have, oh, I didn't get the sponges from the other guy because when I killed him, they would have float straight up in the air, so I didn't get them. Makes sense. Oh, that's what's going on. I was noticing I'm zooming around. It's because there's dolphins outside of this temple, and I'm getting the dolphin effect thing. Ooh, that's cool, but it's not helping me. It's not helping me at all, and it's making me zoom way past where I'm trying to go. So, I beat two of the guardians, and the last one should be at the top of the temple, right? Usually, whoa, this dolphin effect is not very useful in here. Not helpful at all. But I beat two. So the last one, like I was saying, should be, oh my god, this dolphin effect. That's gonna get me killed. It's, look at how, oh wow, I didn't realize it was that fast. But the last one should be at the top is what I was saying. So I think I need to work my way up to the top room somehow and find them. I think they're always in the top of the temple. Oh, I don't think I've been in here yet. No, that's really dark. I don't think I've seen that. Oh my gosh. I've been hunting this whole thing for a long time. Look at this. There's a way up right in the entry room, and that's why I was starting to think that this was going to be impossible. I couldn't find the way up to this guy anywhere, and it was right in the entrance the whole time. There we go. Okay, so that's beat. Zero deaths, pretty easy. The hardest thing about all of this is definitely that new dolphin swimming. It really was throwing me off. But what I want to do now is go ahead and find another one, set up a conduit right below it, and just see if anything changes. If it's way easier, it should be easier. We'll go see. Okay, so I've got the conduit set up right underneath the fort, and to make this a little more challenging, but not really, we're going to take off the helmet, because we should have the whole conduit water-breathing thing the whole time, so I think this will make this way easier if you were able to set one of these up underneath the fort somehow. So let's go ahead and switch into survival, and let's just go at it again. I'm going to use the same tools and everything, because I did pretty well on the last one, so I don't think I need to bother with making another one. But immediately, you know, watching my air, that is amazing and so nice to not have to worry about that and feel like I'm rushed. If we were able to get the conduit and set it up before raiding one of these things, that would make it so easy, really, because it's like, you know, just running around through a temple, basically, trying not to get killed by the monsters. You don't have to worry about any of the oxygen stuff. And why is every single thing a dead end? And I didn't get that until just now, did I? I didn't notice me having the whole mining fatigue thing. I could have been mining my way through this fort. I guess I'm doing it the real way, right? Okay, so pretty much every single room connecting to that central little gold room or whatever, it was a dead end. I'm trying to find my way up first because that was the hardest one for me on the last run. I'm not seeing any kind of way up from here though. Where does this go? This goes up. This goes into another room that will, wait, was I was just in here, wasn't I? I just went around and then went, okay, whoops. Oh, I can hear the conduit killing things. That's really nice, too. That's almost too nice. It's almost like too overpowered or something. Okay, we have our first guy right here just chilling. Should be pretty easy, I think. I think I'm taking a little bit more damage, but that's just because of the whole, you know, no armor thing, or at least no helmet thing. But, wow, this makes it so much less scary. And if I had a trident, I imagine this being so easy. That's one kill down though, so that's pretty much that. And we'll easily get the second one because I just need to swim around this thing. I don't know what's going on with the lighting in here. This could be because of the conduit or something, but it's very, very bright. Even where there is nothing, it's like I have full-on night vision or something. I don't think that's intentional. I think that might be a bug, but I'll go with it. It makes it easier for me to see, right? So why complain? There we go. Kill number two. Now we just need to find the sneaky princess in the top of the monument. That's different, Jen. This is really different generation. This is definitely not normal, right? It's not usually like that. No, it's definitely not. This is different. 100% different. Maybe over here. Let's use one of these to rocket me. Oh, yep, right over there. There we go. We'll rocket into this room and kill this guy. So the conduit definitely makes it way easier. That wasn't even a question, but I just wanted to experiment. There we go. Three kills down. I can switch right back into creative now, and we can go ahead and end this video. So that was pretty fun. I think that's cool. Like I just said, the conduit definitely makes it a lot easier. And honestly, this whole thing is a lot easier because you can see underwater now. That's a big thing. Vision is key. So if you took night vision potions before to this thing, you're probably like, Waddles, it was always pretty easy to see. But I didn't usually. I just took fences and my armor and everything like that. But definitely a lot more enjoyable to raid the thing, a little bit easier, or a lot easier if you're using a conduit. But did you enjoy this video? I hope it entertained you. Very different. Do you have another challenge for me to go and do? I could totally do that. Just throw that down below. If you haven't yet, drop a like on the video, press subscribe, and then go have a good day. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time. Goodbye, everybody.